بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The surah from the Quran that for myself makes a lot of sense in this type of a conversation is a surah that's, you know, very short, to the point, which is part of the eloquence of that surah. And it's a surah that you might actually be quite familiar with. Surah number 103 in the Quran, Wal-Asr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by the fleeting nature of time, like an ice cube that's melting. Time is just running away. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after taking this oath, and you know, one of the things that we learn when we study the tafsir and the meaning of the Quran is that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by something, He doesn't take it just randomly. It's not by random. But it works into the actual message of that surah. It impacts the message that is being delivered. It's setting the stage, creating a visual that will help you, that will aid you in comprehending and internalizing the message of the following verses. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about time as it's slipping away, an ice cube sitting there just melting away, that kind of creates a sense of urgency. Why is that sense of urgency and a little bit of panic, even if you will? Why is that so important? Why is that so necessary? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Because most definitely, without a doubt, the human being, as a species, as an example, as a representative of his entire, of all of mankind, the human being is lafi, is drowning inside, is contained inside of, is trapped inside of ruin, loss. Trapped inside like a bubble. And the only thing that can help this human being burst out of this bubble, break from this containment, free that human being spiritually, emotionally, psychologically, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us what that is going to take. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. The first and foremost thing is to believe. But now what we're talking about in this session is the more practical, the more hands-on. Hence the title of the session, Daily Dose, The Little Things. As Sheikh Yasir was demonstrating and explaining all those little things that go together, that fit together. So, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, the first thing is to believe. Now, but when we talk about the more practical, the daily things, Allah says, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. You know, oftentimes when I speak in forums or venues such as this, I oftentimes encourage, especially younger people, to read the translation of the Quran. Because for somebody who's not really reading or understanding or comprehending, interacting, engaging with the meaning of the divine message, that's why we have so many questions that go unanswered. But at the same time, I'm going to give you a little bit of a disclaimer here. I still wholeheartedly encourage you, it's better than not doing anything at all. Read the translation of the Quran. But when you do read the translation of the Quran, understand that it will have certain limitations to communicate some of the nuances of God's Word. And one of these nuances is here in this very common phrase that repeats itself time and time again throughout the Quran, that is a part of this very basic surah. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except for those who believe, they are able to break out of that bubble, that containment, that circle. And the second thing about those people, Allah tells us, is what normally is translated as, they did good deeds or righteous deeds. But that, like I said, doesn't give you a full appreciation for what Allah is actually saying here. عَمِلُوا means, yes, they acted on, they did, they executed, they did something. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, normally this construction in the Arabic language would be وَعَمِلُوا الْأَعْمَالِ الصَّالِحَةِ. الْأَعْمَالِ is the actions. They did actions. الصَّالِحَةِ would be the adjective. They did good actions. But that's not what Allah said. Allah said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا. They are the ones who did what? الصَّالِحَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are two things here that need to be appreciated. The first one is a little complex. But Allah removed the normal adjective that would be brought and substituted it with an abnormal adjective. There's an abnormal adjective. Normally the adjective of this type of a noun should be singular feminine, as-salihah. But Allah says as-salihat, which is plural feminine. This is considered an abnormality in the Arabic language. An abnormality is done to highlight something. The point of the highlight here, the scholars explain, and there's a precedent of this in Arabic poetry, that when you create this type of an abnormality, you are emphasizing that while it is plural, it is a smaller number. This type of an abnormality would be used to represent something like 3 to 10. And when you would use the more normal adjective, that would be more than 10. A bunch. Dozens and dozens. So the first nuance that I want you to appreciate here is Allah used an abnormal adjective to emphasize the smaller quantity. The second thing that Allah did here was He omitted. He left out the actual noun. He did not say وَعَمِلُوا الْأَعْمَالِ. They did good. They did actions that were good. He just says they did good. He omitted the word actions. And the purpose of that is Allah omitted the actual object but left its adjective, to explain to us that the quantity of your deeds is not relevant. It is the quality that makes them relevant. So basically, after all this technical talk, the point and the objective that I'm trying to communicate here is the way Allah constructs وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, it emphasizes quality over quantity. But then Allah's not done. He says وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ, they continue to advise one another very passionately, very emphatically. They continue to advise one another with the truth. And more importantly, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ, and they continue to advocate and remind and emphasize to one another patience. They continue to advise and recommend patience to one another. The reason why I wanted to talk about this surah in this particular session is that when we talk about the daily things, the point and the essence of it is how our daily lives, our daily existence can become more meaningful. That's really what it gets to. Look, we all have highlights. You know, like, I always apologize for this, especially to the sisters, but a lot of times in my brain, everything has like sports analogies. It's part of the baggage from being from Texas, so it's all football analogies, right? Everybody gets a highlight every now and then. Right, everyone gets a lucky play. There's broken coverage. You know, somebody missed the gap. Somebody missed their assignment. And you get a big play. Somebody runs for 70-yard touchdown. You know, the quarterback sees 50 yards down the field. The wide receiver's running wide open. Who's covering him? That guy lost his place. Everyone gets those lucky broken plays every now and then. But the true definition of success, the teams that are successful, you know, unlike my Cowboys in previous years, make dua for them, inshallah. But I know this is DC, so nobody cares about your Redskins, all right? Say salam to RG3's knee for me, all right? So, but the teams that are successful are those teams that consistently play in and play out, do what needs to be done. Would you generally agree with that? Everyone, even in a more broader sense, in life, everyone's got some highlights. Everyone's got a good day every now and then. But true happiness comes from the fact when every day is just meaningful, productive. Happiness, fulfillment, satisfaction, purpose comes from the fact when every day is meaningful and productive and efficient. And so similarly, spiritually speaking, that's what we're talking about. Friday's a highlight for everybody. Unless you have a terrible khatib, right? But generally speaking, all right? Friday is a highlight for everybody. Ramadan is a highlight for everybody. You know, conference weekend is a highlight for everybody. That's there. But how does every day become more meaningful and spiritual improductive. There are two things. See, because we live in such a quantified culture, quantified society, we count everything. Everything. We found a way to quantify everything. It was bad enough we used to count money as obsessively as we did. Now we count Facebook friends and Twitter followers, and we count everything. Everything has a measure. Everything does. We are products. We will be afflicted by the culture and the society that we live in. And so a lot of times our approach to spirituality is also very quantified. We're counting. We're keeping score. Stop keeping score for a little while. Your relationship is with Allah. You can't keep... When it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you lost a long time ago. You lost a long time ago, if you understand what I'm trying to say. What's the point of keeping score? I'm going to pray as many rak'ahs as blessings Allah has given to me. Wa in tu'uddu ni'matallahi la tuhsuha. You can't even count your blessings. Stop keeping score. Stop counting. Allah is not keeping score as a favor for us. And so the quality of the deed is important. So strive for quality. Emphasize quality. Do a little, but look for quality in that. أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْ And the second thing that the Prophet ﷺ states here and that patience talked about in Surah Al-Asr. The second thing is, once you establish some form of quality, once you are growing in terms of the quality of your experience and your deeds and your actions, they might be very little, but they are starting to become more meaningful. Then the second thing that you need to find now is consistency. Again, don't worry about just growing the quantity from there. No, once you found that quality, from there on forward, now strive for consistency. Those are the two things that our spirituality on a day-to-day basis is built upon. And if we're able to realize quality compounded with consistency, what is the outcome of that? What does that formula lead to? So to get back to quantification, all right, to contradict myself completely, all right, quality plus consistency equals what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in a very beautiful surah of the Quran, surah number 41, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ The people who said, Allah is our Lord. Allah is our master. Allah is our creator. Allah is our sustainer, our maintainer, our provider, our protector, our caretaker. Quality. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا And then they found consistency. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Angels will descend upon them, waves upon waves upon waves upon waves of angels. Some of the narrations in the books of Tafsir mention 70,000 angels are coming down when this person is about to leave this world, breathe their last, depart from this dunya, when their soul is leaving their body, tens of thousands of angels will come down from the sky to welcome and greet this person to the life of the hereafter. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا And they're saying to this person, do not fear what lies ahead, do not grieve over what you leave behind. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ And congratulations, you're going to paradise. You're going to Jannah, the same paradise that you were promised your entire life. Congratulations, you're going. You've punched your ticket to paradise. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ We stuck by your side in the life of the world and we will never leave your side in the life of the hereafter. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ To find quality and consistency, to establish your relationship with Allah. You made all types of sacrifices in the life of the world. You will never have to sacrifice anything ever again. From here on forward, from here on out, every single one of your desires will be fulfilled. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدْ Their own, anything you could possibly ask will be given to you. Nuzulam min ghafurir rahim. And this is just a sample of what awaits for you. Think about the time when you will actually look and gaze upon the face of Allah. That's the outcome of finding meaning and purpose in our daily lives. Quality, consistency. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with both. Jazakumullah khairan.